So it was like Pink Carson's blocked me. Okay. Destroy Wonley's blocked me.
Yeah.
Carti's blocked me. Autumn's blocked me. And Cancan's blocked me. But Cancan fucks with me. He just has me blocked.
Yo, what's going on, guys? You're watching Kids Take Over right now, in New York right now. And bro, I don't even know how to start this interview off. This is like the most unique interview we've done, I feel like. I'm with Hyperpop Daily. I guess that's how I'm gonna shake your hand. I guess the first thing people are wondering, since there's a gazillion things they're wondering, and I'm wondering, tell us about this attire right here. Like, what's going on?
I'm a trash bag.
Okay.
A blue trash bag. Mm-hmm. You know, like that one song, it's like, I'm blue. It's like that, but costume thing.
But, and this, and like...
Yeah, I don't know what this is. I just found this on the street.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, it looks pretty sick, I'm not gonna lie. I feel like you could have done better with the shoes, though, like...
Yeah, if I had some blue shoes, that would have been really cool.
That's what I was thinking, you know? Yeah. But, I mean, I do want to preface one thing, though. I understand that you are hilarious, you know, everything about you is... It's really comical. And you're probably, like, the king of memes, right? But... I don't want to try to like stir things up with this interview or make it like toxic, you know? Like maybe I feel like that's what
I fuck with toxicity.
I know you do, and that's why I want to preface this, because I feel like maybe that's what you're expecting, but I actually am more interested in like your personality for one. Everyone wants to know about that.
I like my vibe.
Your vibe, yeah. And two, just like the business side of things too. I feel like people kind of take for granted like the brand you've built too, you know?
Yeah.
So I want to dive deep into all those things. We will get into a little bit of toxic things, how you know, obviously.
Sure.
But I guess first question I want to ask is like, why do you even want to keep yourself anonymous?
It was hard. Like, you know, you don't know if I'm like OTF or 4PF, you know?
True, you could be either.
That's how I feel with you.
Could be YSL, for all we know.
I could catch Rico tomorrow.
You could. But no one would know, that's the thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, but like, who would replace you, you know?
Probably HBK, if you know who that is, by chance.
HBK?
Yeah, HBK Underground. He ran, like, a meme page.
Okay.
But he got banned, like, 20 times because he's, like, more savage than me, so...
Are you ever scared of that, bro, of, like, getting, like, banned?
No, I'd probably get 20,000 back in the day. I'm not that worried. Like, obviously, like, I take precautions, but...
How have you not gotten seen before, though? That's my question, like...
My vibes are just too raw.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I just dropped a vibe bomb.
Yeah.
And, like, people just don't know what to expect. Because you know what a vibe bomb is?
A vibe bomb. I just feel like it's, like, a plethora of, like, vibes.
No, so you know, like, a regular bomb, like, it would just, like, kill people and shit?
Right.
A vibe bomb, like, if you drop it on people, like, they're not going to die or anything. They're just going to chill out.
Mm.
So it's, like, my new patent, like, the vibe bomb.
So did you, like, throw one in this room? Or?
Yeah, like, there's a vibe bomb going off right now. Like, that's why you guys are all chill.
Yo, you
kind of like it just kicked in. Like.
Yeah. Now it makes sense.
Yeah.
Vibe bomb. I might have to start using that.
Yeah, like shit. I got like a vibe bomb shit on the way. Like, I don't even know.
Yeah, I love it, bro. I mean,
appreciate
so
it.
Who has seen you then? Well, I mean, okay, I'm not gonna lie, guys. I just saw. I'm not gonna deny what. Maybe it's a he or a she. I'm not gonna say, okay. But aside from me and the people in this room. Who has seen you? Like, your mom, dad, obviously, you know?
Unotheactivist and Matt OX.
Wow, that's
cool. Yeah, I, like, met Matt OX at, like, some random venue.
Okay.
I told him who I was. And he just, like, took a picture of me, and he was just like, don't ever talk shit about me or this picture's going on the internet.
Damn.
It's kind of, that's, like, really smart, okay.
No, that actually is really smart, because now you just have to, like, constantly post promos of him, and, like, he can't, you know?
Yeah.
That's pretty smart, honestly. But... Why Matt OX out of all people? How did you put your trust in him that he was gonna like not expose you, you know?
He's like a chill dude. Feels like he definitely has some vibe bombs going off.
He does.
Just kinda like in his own like realm.
And then why Uno out of all people? I thought you had like beef with Uno the Activist.
Uno the Activist beef is very, very funny. Mm-hmm. But like when my page had like 5,000 followers, I would just troll random people because I was bored. Because it got the most engagement. And we kind of went back and forth in DMs on some funny shit. I didn't take it serious. And then me and my friend Jake, we were at this venue. We're just checking it out for the show that we did in LA.
Mm-hmm.
Like a Hyperpop Daily meet and greet.
Mm-hmm.
And Jake helped me with it. And the owner dude, like we were about to leave the venue. We were just checking out to prepare for the next day.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, yo, you guys got to come inside. And I was like, okay. Because I didn't really know what the context was. And it was one of the activists, like, pressing us on the phone.
Pressing you guys?
Yeah, he was like, yo, this is who Hyperpop Daily is. And we just had to, like, apologize that shit. Like, he reverse trolled me. It was hilarious. Damn,
why'd you apologize to Uno the activist, bro?
Because, like, I was trolling him.
Yeah.
But the beef was chill. Like, we're good. Like,
you're good now, though?
Yeah, like, we're, like, best friends now.
Yeah, because he didn't, he, like, oh, best friends.
Not like bestie, but, like, he's like, you know, we're cool.
Okay.
You know, everyone got, like, that one low-key bestie.
True, true. So he's your low-key bestie.
Yeah, he's my low-key bestie, man.
That's what's up. I mean, I know he performed, or not performed, he was, like, playing in your basketball game, so, like, it makes sense.
Yeah, he's playing the next one, too. He's probably going to drop, like, 40 points.
Yeah. I want to get to
like,
that.
Like, his team was balling out teams the first game. It was insane.
Who was on his team?
I don't remember, but it was, like, a bunch of actual dudes who played basketball in their free time. And they were just going up against, like, SoundCloud rappers and kicking ass. It was kind of cool.
Well, like, young Faizo or something? Like,
yeah, bro. Yeah. I don't think Faizo or Nico scored an entire point, like, 1 point.
Well, that's not really surprising. I feel like you look at young Faizo, it doesn't look like an NBA, like, all-star, you know?
No, I feel like he is. Like, he's just, like, you know, like, when you doubt yourself when you're younger, and then, like, you go out and do shit that you wanted to do, and it's like, oh, shit, I was always the GOAT.
Damn.
He's just got to, like, get in the gym, bro. He's got this shit.
Yeah, no, I feel that. I feel that. I want to see how he plays, but... Okay, I want to talk about this. So, like, I want to know about your personality. Like, when Hyperpop Daily was, like, how old are you right now? Can you disclose that?
Probably, like, 37.
37. Okay, cool. That's what I expected.
I don't know my actual age. It's probably, like, 40, 37. Like, I don't have, like, actual, like, ID of my birth.
Okay.
It's really weird.
I was thinking more so, like, 50, but...
Yeah, I was born in, like, where was I born? I think I was born in Seattle.
Okay. We're pretty close then. I live in Vancouver.
Yeah, that's not a real place, but...
What? Vancouver?
Like, I feel like there's, like, a void over the Canadian border. Like, if you drive up to it, there's just, like, nothing.
Didn't you... I swear to God, we were DMing, and you were, like, you told me you were from Toronto or something.
I'm probably lying.
Yeah, you were definitely...
I'd be lying.
I felt like you were trolling me, bro, and, like, at this point, I'm like, everything you say, I don't know if I could believe you.
Yeah, like, I could just be, like, oh, you know, I could be here. This could be my house.
Yeah. Maybe this is your house. I don't know.
How'd you get in here?
That? You let me in.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So okay, tell me this though. What kind of kid were you like growing up, you know, in school? I feel like I can't tell whether you were the class clown or you were the kid that was like in the corner that like had zero friends. I literally don't know.
So. I was dropping five bombs, so I was chill.
Yeah?
Chill dude.
Do you have a lot of friends?
Yeah, a decent amount.
Yeah.
Kind of just in between everything. Nothing like in particular. You know, just like most average person ever.
What was, like, music that you actually listened to, like, growing up?
Ooh. Lil Durk.
Okay.
Lil Durk was hard.
Because
I'm OTF for one.
Right.
Chief Keef.
You just revealed your set, though, because before you left it anonymous, now you kind of...
Wrong, bro. Like, the people got to know what's up, bro. I can't hide it no more.
Eventually,
I'm OTF for life.
Okay, I respect that.
Yeah. Big Chief Keef guy.
Yeah.
Probably any Chicago rapper.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you probably give me a Chicago rapper, I probably know who it is.
Chance the Rapper. Is that...
What the fuck was that on one meme? He was like, oh, I love my life.
Yeah.
Did you ever see that shit?
No, I know exactly what you're talking about. So tell me about, like, the beginnings of the account, because when I go to Hyperpop Daily now, right, I would say that the content has literally nothing to do with the actual name of the brand, you know?
Yeah.
Whereas I know that when you started, it was actual Hyperpop content, right?
Yeah.
So, like, tell me about that. How'd you start, and what was the intent in the beginning?
I liked Hyperpop and, like, the Digicore stuff. I have a lot of respect for those dudes and the stuff they create. And I don't know, I started posting, like, Summrs on some funny shit, because I always liked his music outside of just, like, what I was listening to at the time.
Mm-hmm.
That was stuff that got the most engagement. So I was like, oh, if I keep posting these dudes, I'll probably get more engagement.
Yeah.
And I guess just kind of steamrolled, and I got more fans in that niche than, you know, in the Hyperpop stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So low-key, I was kind of fake and switch, but that's okay because we got money now, so.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
I mean...
Like, sometimes you just gotta switch on your OGs for the bread.
You do sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes you just got to.
If you're struggling, yeah.
Yeah.
But, I mean, were you struggling, though, when you were doing the Hyperpop stuff? Was it not working, or...?
Yeah, we used to go to the corner store and get, like, 50 cent cakes, you know what I'm saying?
Damn, bro.
Yeah.
Well, I'm happy that you switched, bro, because now you're not on the streets anymore, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, you're, like, you're part of the streets, but you're not, like, on the streets, you know?
No, I don't have any affiliation.
Okay, aside from
OTF. My affiliation is God.
Just God, not OTF anymore. Like, it was OTF, but not anymore.
Yeah, like, I thought about it when I said that, and I was like, no, I don't want to do that anymore.
Yeah. I respect that.
Appreciate that.
Yeah, no, for sure, bro. I mean, so how did that morph into like, you know, you posted Summrs, obviously, but like, how did that morph into you posting about that entire scene? And like, you know, when did you notice that you started actually getting an actual like fan base through that?
I don't know. Like, I usually like to look up what people are saying on Twitter. And there was just like days where like 20 people had mentioned Hyperpop Daily on Twitter.
Yeah.
Because I feel like the best way to actually see if someone's relevant, not TikTok, not Instagram, if your name is relevant on Twitter, then you're probably relevant. Because it's really hard to get people's attention on Twitter in terms of like, because like TikTok's more like a view algorithm.
Mm-hmm.
Instagram, you can just scroll through your feed and you'll see shit. Twitter's a lot different because you really have to be, like, Twitter basically caters towards the kind of content you're looking for.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're just pulling random people out your ass who enjoy what you're doing on Twitter, and they're talking about you by name, you're doing something right.
Yeah.
So when I noticed I was getting, a bunch of people either making fun of my page or doing some fucking deep analogy on my page or some shit, that's when you really know, like, oh, I actually have something of value.
But what about, okay, so on Instagram, when did you start noticing you were getting, like, hell, because bro, I'm gonna be honest, your engagement is incredible. And what I mean by this is that, you know, I'm in the game, so I understand. There's accounts like rap or like just a bunch of hip hop pages, and they'll have like 200,000 followers, right?
Which and they'll get like two likes.
Yeah, okay, well, yeah, not two, but you got what I'm saying. Like, they'll get low likes and like low comments, but your engagement rate is like incredible. You know, you have a cult fan base of people actually like. Dude, you'll post a picture of like a dog, okay?
That picture goes hard.
And it'll get like 150 comments. And like, you will post multiple pictures of dogs. It's not like one dog, you know? So I guess what I'm trying to say is like, how did you get such a cult fan base? Like the moment you post, they'll comment like that.
Because people like think too hard about like life and Instagram. They don't want to have fun. I'm just like, I don't really care. I just want to post pictures of dogs. I don't give a shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if I want to talk about Summrs or Hyperpop, I'll talk about Summrs or Hyperpop. But sometimes I just want to post a dog.
Yeah. I mean, I respect
sometimes that. I just want to post, like, Lil Durk. Yeah. I know he's not Hyperpop, but I'll couple Lil Durk. So it's like...
Yeah. Have you ever thought of changing the name? Because that's not... I feel like that's what makes it funny, is, like, that's not what you post, so that's, you know, that's cool about the name. Have you thought of, like, changing the name ever?
I feel like I can't at this point.
You can't?
Yeah, it's like a spiritual, like, deity. Like, you can't change it.
Well, if you could change it to one thing, right, off top of your head, what would you change it to?
Raw Vibes Daily.
It's raw. What's the matter with you?
Raw Vibes. Or Vibe Bombs Daily would not.
Vibe Bombs Daily.
VB.
They don't know about VBD. This Vibe Bomb shit, bro.
Yeah. Now you're introducing a new wave, I feel like.
Yeah. Vibe Bombs are going to be everywhere.
I mean, okay, bro.
That's well, after another one, by the way.
No, I noticed. Don't worry. I noticed. I didn't say anything bad.
Yeah, understood.
Yeah.
Just nonchalant.
Yeah. I mean, so do you ever feel like, I feel like when you got really popular, honestly, this is what I think, is when you started posting, like, beef-related things, your engagement went to, like, a different high, okay?
Yeah.
Do you ever feel like you're kind of instigating with things? Like, I know you see, like, academics, well, he'll not, like, he won't write in the captions, like, yo, this guy sucks or this guy sucks, but he will post about if someone says someone else sucks, you know? Which I mean, is like what you do, essentially.
I feel like it'd be different if it was like rappers, you know, like the fucking New York drill scene, because that's like actual serious shit that happens in, you know, neighborhoods and shit.
Mm.
But do you really feel as if like Can and Summrs are really going to go to like spin Ken Carson's block? Like, let's be serious.
Well, here's the thing,
though.
Let's
like be 100% serious.
Okay, I'm trying to be 100% serious. I just can't with the mask. I just think that, I don't know, like, I fuck with all their music, by the way. I just want to point that out. But I don't know. Like, are they? I don't know. You're telling me no. Okay, that's what the vibes I'm getting
from. Bro, I feel like Can just, like, plays, like, Madden all day or some shit.
Mm-hmm.
And he hops on, like, some rage beat from, like, some European producer and calls it a day. Like he doesn't really care about it. He'd be dropping hard songs, you know what I'm saying?
But, I mean, you see their music videos, bro. Like, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure a lot of it is, like, props. But, you know, you see, like, the beefs, like, with... When things happen with Jace and all those people, like, it seemed pretty serious to me.
Yeah, that one's a little different, but let's be real. Everyone was using that for engagement, so I don't feel as morally bad.
Yeah. Have you ever felt morally bad? Like, damn, maybe I shouldn't have posted that.
Depends.
Yeah?
Like, I have a few posts in mind in my head that I'm like, yeah. Because, like, sometimes I just don't know the context of the situation seriously, and then someone corrects me, and I'm like, oh, and I take the post down.
Right. Yeah, you have taken a lot of posts down, I've noticed.
Yeah, like, I try to be, like, really good about, like, respecting people's pronouns and shit like that. So, like, if I do something wrong with that, like, I'll just take it down. Because I'm really trying to be good on shit like that. You know, if I get, like, a certain detail about, like, a beef or something wrong, yeah, I'll take it down. Like, I try not to be, like, a hater-hater. Yeah. Like, I'm a hater, but not, like, a hater-hater.
I wouldn't say you're a hater.
I'm kind of a vibe curator.
Vibe curator is more so the word. Nah, for sure. I mean, yeah. I know the page is, like, 80% satire, right? Well, like, let's say, like, 96% satire.
Yeah.
I notice a lot of artists, though, they take a lot of jokes seriously, like, way too seriously. And that's happened with your page. So what happens in a scenario like that? It's, let's say it's an artist you genuinely like, but they just got mad at you for, you know, making such an obvious joke. Like, how do you feel when something happens?
Yeah, there's a lot of artists in particular that I just don't post because, like, I know they take their career super serious. So
what's the list?
I can't really say. It's just, like, one of those things. I don't want to put anyone out there.
Yeah. But there's definitely, I don't know, man. I feel like there's definitely people you post that don't like it, but you still post them.
Yeah, because Summrs is a goat.
Yeah?
I'll post a goat anyways.
So in order for you to post someone that doesn't like what you post, they just have to be goated, basically.
Yeah.
I don't know, because then, like you post Ken Carson, right?
I get paid to do that.
Okay.
Not a big Ken Carson fan, I'm not going to lie.
Okay.
I think his music's burnt out.
Okay. So did you not like X?
It's really bad.
Really bad?
Really bad. They destroy Only Guy, though.
Yeah?
They destroy Only Fan.
So out of the two albums, like, No Silence,
like, changed my life. I just think that Ken Carson just dropped the most mid album of the year.
Damn. So what about Project X, though? That was sick.
That was hard.
Yeah.
But he just, like, he's not just, like, doing anything that's changing anything to me, so.
I hear this a lot, though, because, like, exactly what you just said, I hear it a lot. So what do you think that Destroy Lonely is doing so different that Ken Carson is not doing?
You can definitely tell that he does take inspiration from Carti and what he curated, mm-hmm, but he definitely adds his own swagger to it and shit. Mm-hmm. Like, I hate, like, talking about this shit now because it's so played out by Opium fans, but, like, you know, small shit like Catholic churches and, like, the 0.5 filters and shit. It's just, like, small shit like that can really differentiate, like, your aesthetic from, like, you know, like, right, Carti. I feel like Ken Carson's definitely more of a follower. He doesn't really have anything too unique from Carti.
Damn, but I feel like Lone, like, in terms of at least, like, dressing and the filters and stuff, he does the same thing, no?
Yeah, he does, but he's got his own spin on it, is what I'm trying to say.
Like, in terms of how he dresses or the music?
Both. Okay. And, like, his flow is, like, he's just got such a unique flow. Like, he's literally a genius.
Right. Damn, okay. Have you ever DM'd people like Destroyed, like anyone in Opium, have you ever DM'd them and like gone a response?
Ken Carson messaged me once because like there was these dudes making like fake merch of his when he was dropping his new album,
yeah,
like same day, trying to make a quick talk off hype and shit. And then I just posted it just to like, you know, stay current with the news, like, oh, Ken Carson merch link. And then Ken Carson DMs me. And like, you know, like the fucking lowercase currency shit he does.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he messaged me and fucking Twitter DMs like that on some cringe shit.
So what was the actual phrase?
It was like, send me link to like fucking like the merch and why are you supporting? I just said sorry. Yeah. And he didn't reply. And then like the RR beef happened and I was just like, went back to his DMs in all caps and I was like, RR forever.
And did he see that at least?
I don't know. He didn't block me, so that's a positive.
Oh, he didn't block you?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
He blocked me on Instagram. Okay. So did Lonely, and Carti, and Can, and Autumn.
Okay, that's like quite the list. Okay, wait, sorry. I'm losing track. Repeat the list again. So
it was like Ken Carson's blocked me, okay. Destroy Lonely's blocked me,
yeah.
Carti's blocked me, Autumn's blocked me, and Can's blocked me. But Can fucks with me, he just has me blocked.
How does that make any sense?
Because I'm probably annoying, but that's okay.
Okay, fair, but how do you know that he fucks with you, though?
Because he says so on Twitter.
Okay.
Like, yeah, he's funny sometimes.
That's pretty sick. Like, I think out of all those things, it's low-key an accomplishment that you got blocked by Carti. Because, like, for him to take time out of his day to click the three dots and go to the block, you know, I feel like you must have got his attention, at least.
Yeah.
Is that, like, on the list of,
he just wants to be me, to be honest.
That, too, for sure. I can see that. But is that like on the list of like your accomplishments, is that you got blocked by Carti?
Probably top 20.
Top 20?
Yeah.
What's like your number one then?
That's tough. Yeah. One time, like, I was mentioning Summrs when he had his main account still. Mm-hmm. And I asked him if he fucks with Blade. Mm-hmm. And he said, like, I don't know who that is, but he liked a Blade post back in like 2018, so he was capping. Mm-hmm. I caught him lacking, basically.
That's a pretty sick accomplishment.
Yeah.
Did you post that you caught up lacking? I feel like you definitely had
to
do that.
Yeah, fair.
And that probably did really well, right?
Yeah, it probably did like 8,000 likes.
Something light.
Yeah,
something light. That's what's up. I mean, okay, I guess last person I want to ask about is Bobalam. Because, yo, look, Bobalam is my homie, okay? I understand that...
It's Bob K for L.
Huh?
Bob K for L.
What do you mean by that?
Like, I'm a Bob killer.
Oh, you're a Bob killer?
Yeah.
How did that start, bro? I feel like, I thought you guys would get along. You guys seem like the... Your vibe bombs and like his vibe bombs, I feel like would kind of.
I feel like he doesn't fuck with my vibe bomb, bro.
Really?
Yeah, bro. I feel like he just kind of like fuck with me like that.
But how do you know that?
Probably because I'm an asshole and I was trolling him.
Okay, well, that so that you admit it's your fault.
I mean, like, I don't take accountability for anything, though.
Yeah.
Like, I take accountability for the vibes. Like, that's it.
Right. But you were giving off bad vibes then in that case, no?
No, I only give off good vibes. Like, people just read the room wrong.
Oh, okay. So he just read it kind of wrong. So it's like, okay.
I feel like, if I'm trolling you and you take it serious.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
Yeah. I feel that. I mean, okay, well, I guess, okay, no, sorry. I do have to ask about one more person. What about Yeat? Have you ever tried?
Yo,
no,
he's really cool.
Yeah. Because you guys have DM'd, and I know there's like memes made of your guys' DMs.
Yeah. I remember I invited him to go to like the HPV meet and greet. And
he was in
like,
Hawaii.
Can't in Hawaii then. Mm. That was a real DM. People thought it was fake, but he did ask DM me that.
Yeah. Wait, it wasn't Ken. He said, like, Kaint.
Yeah, that's really funny.
Yeah, there's a difference.
Yeah. But he's a really cool dude. I feel like he really appreciated some of the posts I did for him when he was coming up.
Did he ever, like, engage with them?
Yeah, he engaged with one, which was super cool.
Yeah.
Super chill dude. Great management.
Nextel?
Yeah, Nextel is a fucking genius. Yes. One of the most smart people ever. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, Yeat really deserves everything he's gotten, for sure.
Well, I'm going to say this. Many people might not take your page super, super seriously, but coming from someone who also runs like a hip-hop brand, right? I think that you've built a lot of value in your brand, bro. And I know this because I have friends in the industry who have, like, tried to buy your page. I've had friends who've literally tried to buy your page. And what I'm trying to say is...
I got offered, like, 30,000.
Yeah, well, bro, I think you should get offered more than that.
Yeah, this was back when I had, like, 20,000.
Yeah. I'm saying, like, now, I feel like, I don't know, would you ever sell the page or something like that?
Bro, fuck yeah, I would cash the fuck out.
Really?
Bro,
but for how much?
I don't want to do this shit anymore. Please get me out of here.
Oh, God.
Bro, if I get 100,000, y'all will never hear from me again, please.
Nah, bro, you could get more than 100,000.
Bro, I'll do anything, bro. Just give me some bread.
I don't think you understand, though, bro. I think that you have built a really, like, high-value brand in the sense where, like, you have people constantly commenting on your stuff. You have an image to you. This is, like, something that other brands die for, you know? Like, they can never get. So, don't sell the page for 100K, dude.
Bro, like, I don't know. Someone pulls out 100 bands, bro, I'm not fold. I'm not going to lie. I might get a help cap, bro.
Yeah?
Yeah. I got to shoot with Durk tonight.
That is tempting to get. No, I feel that. Mm. I get you. But do you think that your fans understand, like, the importance of your brand and, like, how valuable it is? Or do you think that they just see it as, like, another meme page?
They probably see it as a meme page because they're all dumb and probably, like, 12. Like, yeah. The average, like, I feel like the average Hyperpop Daily follower is probably, like, 10 years old.
Okay, 10 years old. What's three other characteristics you would describe?
Don't shower.
Okay.
Uses Discord, social outcast.
Okay.
That's probably the main four.
Fair. That makes sense. Do you think Hyperpop Daily fans get girls or no?
No.
Not at all?
Mm-mm.
Do you get girls?
Always.
Yeah.
I'm a boss.
Or guys, because we don't want to disclose whether you're
a guy. I get whatever I want.
Yeah.
100 emoji. I catch vibes, bro. We already spoke about the vibe now.
Okay, wait. What's the last date you've been on? That's what I want to know.
Probably a few weeks ago, actually.
Okay, what's Hyperpop Daily's ideal? Like, where are you taking a girl?
Ooh, probably a nice Italian place.
Okay.
I fuck with Italian food.
You give off the vibe of you like Italian food, you know? You seem
that's
like
that's really random.
I know.
You I don't seem know if like, I trust that.
No, I promise, dude. I wouldn't just randomly say that to you. I feel like
you. Why do I give off the vibes of an Italian food type of guy, though?
It's just the vibe bomb that you gave me.
The vibe bomb like subconsciously hit you, and that's what it gave you.
Yeah.
Understood.
Thank you, bro. Thank you. Okay. How do you measure success aside from just, okay, I get comments and people are following me? Like, what actually makes Hyperpop Daily happy? Because I can't tell. I can't tell money. Sometimes whether you hate what you do or whether you love it.
I like money. Okay. Big money guy.
Yeah.
Yep. So, like, if I make a lot of money, I'm happy. I want to do something that's unique with, like, interviews. I want to play, like, Uno with, like, rappers and shit.
Would you like
wear like this? Board games and shit. Nah, I'd probably like be under a new persona and you wanna know it's me.
So would you not start the channel as Hyperpop Daily or what would you do?
I don't know, man. Like that's the part. I don't know what I wanna do yet.
Yeah.
But I wanna do some shit where I play a board game with artists and shit. I feel like that'd be fun. Like not a straightforward interview. Yeah. Like I guess just bring a rapper in the room and we just play a board game for like an hour and just record it.
But would you wanna do it with a random rapper or would you wanna do it with like someone that you watch, you know?
Yeah, I definitely want to do it with someone that I, like, you know, respect, but at the same time, like, I'm down with meeting new artists and new perspectives and shit.
How do you see your platform different than one like mine, you know? Because I think we do pretty different things, but we're in a similar space. But have you ever thought of, like, pivoting more in my direction or something like that?
Yeah, I feel like it's just too late to do it, though. Mm-hmm. Like, you're a genius, and, like, I'm just kind of a shitposter. That's the difference.
But that's the thing, though. I don't think that's what I'm trying to convey in this interview to people watching. Is like, I also think you're a genius. You just don't do it in like a. How do I say
this? Just like a chaotic neutral.
It's you're just like less artistic, I would say. But at the end of the day,
I'm more artistic than anything.
Really?
Because like, not necessarily in terms of like how I do business. That's probably where I'm less articulate. But like. In terms of like the artistic of the page is probably the biggest part of it, right?
Okay, no.
I think artistry.
Right. I think what I'm trying to say is like, how do I say this? It's like less of like a brand and more of like a cult, if that makes sense.
You know? For sure.
But okay, you think it's too late. I feel that. I mean, where I could see your North Star being like, you know, your end goal is like academics. Because academics has built
like just like fall off a bridge, respectfully.
Really?
Fuck academics, bro. He's like.
Damn, why?
Because, like, he basically, like, instigated gang wars in Chicago.
Okay.
Which is, like, really lame.
Okay, aside from that, I'm saying, like, the way he operates his business, like, his voice is so strong. He has a cult fan base. And I could see you doing what he does.
Like, academics is an incel.
Really?
Yeah, bro. Did you see that video on Twitter about him and that one girl?
Oh, when he was
hit? He definitely gets no bitches.
No, he gets bitches, which is surprising.
He's
that's
not
the crazy
dropping
part.
No vibe bombs, bro.
No.
He's dropping no vibe
bro, academics bombs. Gets bitches, and it's sad, I'm going to be honest. But when you have that much clout, like, anyone can get bitches. You don't have to be like...
Bro, he was, like, yelling at some girl, and he was, like, on the end goal. It's, like, get a job, bro.
Yeah?
It's, like, damn. People like that. Like, I just troll, but when I see people get ahead like that, it's so cringe to me.
Yeah. Would you never do that? Like, you would never get ahead of
yourself?
That's
why I don't want to reveal myself, because, like, I don't want to be a figure in that sense. Like, I just want to post funny shit on the internet.
I see. So you would never go and, like, stream like academics does and, like, talk about...
No, I probably would under, like, a different name, because then I'd enjoy it. But I know if, like, the fan base I have on Hyperpod Daily, I wouldn't enjoy it.
Right. Okay, I'm going to ask you a direct question.
What's up?
What's the ways that you make money off Hyperpop Daily? I know the main way, which is, I'm guessing, promo.
Yeah. Right?
So, but you tell me.
That's definitely the main way. Mm-hmm. I know you can do subscriptions on Instagram, which is cool.
Mm-hmm.
My friend, Underground Sound, he's got that going on. And what he does is he basically just gives advice to artists on a more personal level with it, which is really cool.
Mm-hmm.
I like when... platforms do that for artists, especially artists who are just looking to actually market themselves, because I know, like, me and you should decide, it can be very hard for artists to get their foot in the door and know what they're doing that. So I think, like, platforms like yours and Underground Sound do a really good job at that,
yeah.
Which is cool. I just know that I can never do anything like that.
So okay, what about, okay, you said promo and merch, right? Promo, I feel like I have so many thoughts on promo. Like, we could have a hour conversation about that.
You make
but
a lot of money off of it. That's crazy.
Yeah, you can make a lot of money off of it. So, like, how many promos are you doing per day? And, like, you know, What do you charge for your promos? I'm actually just curious.
2 to 4. Right now, probably like 200.
Okay. Nice.
And then I'll do bundles for more, obviously. It just depends on who I'm working with. A lot of labels and shit like that. Mm-hmm. Probably going to up the price once I hit like 100,000 or just keep going.
Right.
Something I usually reevaluate at the end of the year.
How do you feel about doing promo? Like, are you... Because the thing about your page and another page, right, is if another page posts a really shitty artist, people will literally unfollow that page. If you post a really shitty artist, like, that's funny, you know?
Yeah, because, like, I don't care, and, like, I'm going to put money over anything else, and that's why it's funny.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sorry, like, do I care about, like, the integrity of my page or $200? Let's be serious.
Right. $200, of course.
Like, yeah, obviously. Like, I could use that to pay my rent. You think I give a fuck about, like, what some random person is going to pay on Instagram?
Fair.
You know what I'm saying?
That's respectable. So what's the biggest check, like, you've made off Hyperpop Daily in general? Like,
let's probably say, like, 5,000, 6,000 a day.
Really? And that was through things just like promo?
Yeah, that was more campaign-centric.
Right. Okay. Well, where do you draw the line for promo? Because, like, is there ever a thing where you're just like, nah, bro.
Yeah, not someone honest. Sent me a video of them pissing once, and I was like, I'm not posting this, bro. Like, obviously there wasn't, like, any nudity, but they were just, like, dead-ass pissing the songs in the back. And I was like, this is gross.
Well, what's $200?
Bro, but, like, nobody wants to see you, like, piss. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's, like, levels of gross. There's, like, different levels of gross. If there's blood, you can't have that either.
I see. Okay. Well, you say that as you're wearing a scream mask, but...
yeah, but it's blue.
Oh, fair. It's not red, at least. Okay. All right. I'm going to hit you with a random question, okay?
For sure.
Who's Hyperpop Daily's top 5 rappers of all time?
Ooh. Well, I would generally would sit down and listen to.
Yeah.
Yo, number one. Should I start from 5 or 1?
Start with 5, bro. We gotta get there.
Then I'm going to start with 1, then, because you told me to do the opposite. So number 1 is probably Summrs.
Okay,
I got it. Summrs guy. Number 2 is probably Chief Keef.
Okay.
Big Chief Keef guy. Number 3, probably Shine. Well, Shine's a goat.
Okay, I know you've recently been posting about.
Yeah, he's really cool.
Yeah.
Number 4 is probably Kelly Clarkson.
That's a fairly valid pick, yeah.
Number 5 is probably Rihanna.
Okay. A little mix. I thought you would say, like, Playboi Carti, maybe.
He's cool. I don't bump his shit like that.
Not like Kelly Clarkson?
Kelly Clarkson for life.
Right. Fair. Okay. Well, that's an interesting top 5. Okay, cool. Well, I know you spend a lot of time on your day on Photoshop, right?
Unfortunately.
Yeah. Do you ever get bored or tired of just, like, sitting on the computer and being the one to physically make the posts? Because, like, in my instance, right, I've kind of taken a step back where I come up with a lot of the ideas, or, like, I'll oversee the ideas, but you know I can't physically make the posts anymore. So have you ever thought of, like, hiring people to do things like that? Or
yeah, like, when I'm out overseas or something like that, I'll have my friend do it. And then sometimes I'll, you know, I'll sell him $50, I shoot, just some casual stuff.
Yeah. But do they do it like you, you know? Like, can someone do it like
you? It's usually just usual promo. Like, if I can't make the memes, I'll just post some random shit, like Migos Chanel Fortnite.
Right. Those are, like, your backup posts, and they do well anyway, so. Yeah.
Like, the people want to know who would win, Migos Chanel Esports or Don Corleo Gaming. That's, like, the real, like, question society has, you know?
But what do you think?
Like, who would win?
Yeah.
Probably Migos Chanel Esports in 7.
Okay.
I feel like it would be really close, though.
Yeah, okay. Is he playing at the new tournament, by the way?
Oh, Nico?
Yeah.
Yeah, and Dom's going to be there, too.
So. Okay. That's pretty cool, bro. I feel like you've curated, like, a pretty sick list of, like, people. I mean, I'm playing, too, which is
cool. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, it's going to be. And, like, how many people are playing in that?
I believe it's 80. 80 total. We've probably announced, like, 40, 50 so far.
Yeah. So isn't it kind of funny, though, because, like, technically, you can show up to the games, but no one will know that you're there.
That's the genius of it, right?
So were you there?
Yeah,
I was there. That's lit, bro. That's actually, like, are you going to be at this next one?
Maybe.
Because now, all anyone has to do is just look at everyone in the room and be like, okay, one of these people is Hyperpop Daily.
That's a lot of people. That's the genius of it.
True.
You don't know if I'm going to be there.
Yeah. Maybe you'll be, like, peeking from, like, far away or something.
Yeah, I could be, like, in a high rise, just, like, binoculars or some shit looking down.
Right, right. Just spectating it. Yeah. That's fair. Well,
Batman shit.
Yeah. Well, hey, bro, I just want to say I respect it. I think that as like a business owner, you know, I actually respect what you've done a lot. I think it's pretty cool. And I want to see, like, obviously you've done these events. I want to see where you take it next. I think that you can be doing streams. You could be doing like a podcast. So I guess the last thing I want to ask in this interview is just like, what's like the end goal or like the future like for Hyperpop Daily?
I just want to do YouTube content. Mm-hmm. I don't think I ever want to reveal myself because I just have too much fun doing this shit. But I definitely have shit I want to do outside of this. But obviously, that is very classified information that the general public cannot know. So, but otherwise, yeah, really want to focus on YouTube stuff. I think that's really what I want to take my audience and my creative journey.
Yeah. Hell yeah, bro. What's your message to the youth? Because a lot of young people watching this video right now.
Catch a vibe.
Catch a vibe. Yeah, I respect it. I'm just going to end this interview off with shaking his hand right here. And yeah, it's Hyperpop Daily Kids Takeover interview. We'll get it. Yo, guys, thank you for watching that Hyperpop Daily interview. She was super cool. If you did enjoy it a lot, trust me, go like and subscribe to the channel. That shit really helps. And like, I just want you guys to follow the journey. More sick interviews. I think we got Dom Corleo next week. And then like a pretty mainstream rapper the week after that. I'm just excited. Also, I'm gonna be playing at that game, the basketball game in January in New York. So I'm gonna see you there, and I'm gonna drop like 6 points.